At 11 a.m., the body of the Indian moneylender Uttam Bhandari, who was shot dead by Police Constable Ivan Wawire, was delivered at Lugogo Hindu Crematorium. Family and friends carried the body from the ambulance and walked in a procession while singing culture songs.
Jai Jinendra!
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 Jai Jinendra! Jai Jinendra!
Members of the Indian community performed a series of traditional funeral rites, and family members broke down in tears as the moment of cremation came to reality. After traditional rituals, they proceeded to cremate the body with firewood. Mourners condemned the escalating cases of gun violence and urged security agencies to step up. The Indian community, however, noted that the murder of their own is not a target on the community, since Ugandans, including the former Minister of State for Labor, died in a similar circumstance.
One thing is, as always, the community has come together, and this time even the Ugandan community has come in a bigger way to come and support us. This security issues, which we keep talking and we do all the time, it's not only concerning the businesses, it is concerning all the sectors of all the aspects within Uganda, and it is concern of 43 million people.
Kenya, Somalia, people will run away from a gunman. If they see a gunman there, then they'll walk here. Uganda is the only country in the region where people openly talk and confront with gunmen. We are seeing a result of very many factors, but at the end of the day, we are Hindus. We profess different faiths. I know there are Christians and Muslims here, but Uttam was a Jain believer, and Jainism, they say, we all come and go, we are visitors on earth, and each of us has a time to go, and that's the way we go. So today was his time. Tomorrow it will be mine or yours.
Immediate family members broke down while addressing mourners, saying they can't relate with a CCTV clip showing a police officer ending the life of their brother. In this regard, the Indian community pleaded with the public to stop sharing the traumatizing video.
I couldn't sleep watching those videos, and it was shocking. I just want to thank everyone. I think some of you I know and some of you I don't know, and that speaks what Uttam achieved in the last 4 years, and that two years out of that was COVID. So I think it's not us who has lost him. I think all of us have lost a great human being who was really trying to contribute to the prosperity of Uganda, and he was really humble person. I've never seen him shouting. I've never seen him getting aggressive.
Speaking at the burial, the president of the Hindu Council of Africa, Dr. Rajin Taylor, urged government to deploy policemen at all financial institutions, including banks and forex bureaus, to mitigate criminality.
I condemned what took place on Friday. Our prayer to the government that they should restore the security at the bank and the forex bureau by providing the police officers. I was informed that there are no more police officers in the forex or in the bank, but only the private guard.
Members of parliament who sit on the parliamentary forum on Indian affairs, led by their chairperson Fred Opolot, graced the burial and committed to push for justice.
His Excellency has rightly these questions equally should press the Uganda police force to give the nation answers in the wake of these sorts of senseless shootings. As we all call for an expedited investigation into this matter.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.